All right, so yay. Okay, back to the sheet I've been working on. So, I've been testing it and testing it, and it's like, oh, I found a whole bunch of things, but it works now really good, except for it just saves slow. It saves very, very slow. And when I mean save slow, it's like, well, the I even deleted a large sheet. I even got rid of menus, all kinds of things. But it is 100 villages. It is five for 5,000 property owners. So it's a big sheet, a big worksheet. But it is working really, really well. I think I got out all of those weirdo things, like if you sell the house, I added a field for this that you list for selling, and I got all the instructions a little clearer in my head. Yeah, when I write these sheets, I don't even really know how it's all going to happen. It just materializes little by little. Yeah, but yeah, I figured out the instructions of the sales, and they're very clear. I also figured out like if somebody, because when a sale happens and out to a new villager, it's a total strange event, and that means really that the person that was the original villager is leaving. And so at that moment, out they go. So their data has to be kept, and so I made a left sheet. They have to go to the left sheet, and then they have also the sales sheet. They have to have their data go to the sales sheet. So particular data goes there. But so there is a little bit of that type of work. But other than that, I think it's pretty easy to handle. The swap sheet though is a little difficult to look at, reading wise, legibility wise. I created like 13 different swap scenarios, and they're not just all in a tidy little row, because one swapper could be out there on his eighth swap, and somebody's only swapped to their house once. And so it's matching up all the, so that's a little awkward, but it does work as long as you know which house number you're swapping into and which house number you're leaving from. So it can all be finagled to be fine. Yeah, so the only thing that's really lacking in it is I don't have a cost yet, a cost of all of the builds. I have a great estimate, very great estimate, but when you get into those the nitty-gritty details of how much exactly is the build gonna be, for a cob, for the ram, for the straw bale, for this, for that, for the hobbits, for the tree houses, for the teepees, all of them have their own little cost happiness. So anyway, I think it's really gonna be great, and it works. My only sad is it's so governmental in size that I actually think it needs to be shrunken. So I will make a shrunken version with only like 10 villages. I think that's the only way to go with it. I hate to do that though, because that's such a limiter, because it's like, what if you get the 10 village version? You'll be like, well, that's great. They can barter, they can exchange items, they can, be like our own little group. That's wonderful. However, after 10 villages, what if they want another one, and so they would have to switch to the larger sheet, and the jump from 10 to 100 in spreadsheet world is huge. It's a huge jump when you're talking, 500 people versus 5,000. So I am excited for it. I think it's really great. I think it's really great. Anyway, I know I said it was almost like a week ago that I was finished, but I don't know. I guess there's a tester phase that goes on. And then sometimes I'm like, uh-oh, I uploaded the wrong sheet, and then I had to go backtrack and get the, and do things all over again. But yeah, it's doing really great. It's doing really great. Anyway, so this is more of the sheet update for this, the 100 Echo Villages. Yeah. And it's so sad, really, because if you think about it, it's only 5,000 main property owners that it encompasses. And yet, you know, it seems like such a lot, and it's not. It's not when you look at the, you know, the populations out there. It's just not at all. I know it. It seems massive, like it's a big undertaking, like it's just going to handle. But yeah. And obviously, I did things like with specialties, like if you have other specialties, you can include other specialties and give them a code. I made code groups, so that helps the finder. So if you're, you know, the matching the villages, you know, finding, like if you want to be all with people who sing, you want to be with all people who do pottery and artwork, they it all goes with a matching code. So that groups them all together, so it kind of helps out. So if there's not any places in a pottery village, at least you could get into another artisan village. So it kind of keeps you in that strain. So that was kind of cool. Anyway, yeah, I'll end of this. But yeah, I think I'm done for a while with it. And I don't think I uploaded any refs or you know, those terrible things. I think it's all cleared out. Yeah. Yikes. Wow. Why do I do these massive sheets? I don't know. It's ridiculous.